I'm gonna go ahead and taste the crema on this. I'm not really getting any peppermint from the smell, so let's see. Let's just taste the coffee. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah. Well, I try to tell you so. Yes, I did. But I guess you didn't know. As I said, the story told. Maybe now I got the flow. Cause I know it from the start. Welcome back to Coffee and Kay. I am Kay, and in today's video, I am going to be trying out the Peppermint Pinwheel Pod, which is a part of their holiday collection, limited edition. They did release this last year, however, I did not try it, so this will be my first time trying the pod. This is what the box looks like. There it is. I'm gonna go ahead and try it black per usual, try the crema if I can get any, and then I'm gonna put some milk in it and maybe a syrup. If you're interested, please stay tuned. But before we get started, please make sure you like this video, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel. And when you do subscribe, please don't forget to hit the notification bell so you are notified whenever I upload a video. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so we are reviewing the Peppermint Pinwheel Pod. It is limited edition. This is what the box looks like, and this is what the pod looks like. It's a really pretty holiday green color, and I did notice also that the foil here is a bit, it's thinner, I guess, than the other ones are. That may be something new they're trying, but this is what it looks like. It's a really pretty pod. It is a coffee pod, 7.77 ounces. The aromatic profile is candied and sweet, and the aromatic notes are sweet, candy, and peppermint. This, like the pepper, or like the pumpkin spice cake pod, is also half caffeinated, half regular, so it's only a half calf. It says that with the addition of a dash of milk, the lingering notes of peppermint soften to achieve a well-balanced milky cup. I am really looking forward to trying this. I honestly have heard good and bad about it, but for the most part, the reviews seem to be pretty positive. I'm gonna go ahead and brew a cup off camera, and then I'll bring you back, and then we'll go ahead and give that a try. You go, girl, you know how I've been living without you. Daydreaming on a cloud with you like the horizon. With you tonight is on a violin. Yeah. It's about time for waking up. Found you wasn't with me waking up. Now you feel set up to you, miss your touch. I needed to distance myself from you. I was just in love with you. Okay, so I have my cup here that's been brewed. This is the milk I'm using today. It's the Oatly Oat Milk Barista Edition. So I have my milk frothing. I just put a half a cup in there in the arancino. I'm gonna go ahead and taste the crema on this. I'm not really getting any peppermint from the smell, so let's see. Let's just taste the coffee. From the coffee itself, I wouldn't say it's an overwhelming amount of peppermint. Whereas I know with the pumpkin spice cake, when you had it black, you definitely tasted the pumpkin spice in the coffee. So maybe let's just add the milk and see. I'm not gonna rule it out yet. Again, I've heard really positive things. So let's
Okay, so let's go ahead and add the milk to it. I'm gonna go ahead and give that a stir, combine everything together. There's a faint scent of peppermint, but nothing too crazy. Adding the milk to it, it does give it a nice texture. Adding the milk does give it a nice texture, but I would say I get faint notes of peppermint. It's not overwhelming. Yeah, I'm not overwhelmed with the taste of the peppermint. It's a good cup of coffee. I guess maybe I was expecting more. It is a really nice cup of coffee, smooth, mild cup, obviously because it's half calf, but it's very mild, nice, smooth when I add the milk. It's very smooth cup of coffee, but I'm not really getting much of the peppermint from it. I may have to play with it. I do actually have a mini peppermint syrup from Monin that I may try with it. However, my intention when I bought the pod was to buy a peppermint pod. I didn't want to have to doctor it or add peppermint to it. So that's not really, it's kind of pointless, I guess. For syrups, I'm going to go ahead and add the creme de cacao from Tarani, peppermint, dark chocolate. I mean, it is what it is. I'm just going to add this much. Oh, it's kind of thick. There we go. And let me stir that up a little bit more. Okay. It is good, the syrup added to it. It's already a good cup of coffee. Adding the syrup to it, it doesn't take away from it. But again, I don't really get much of the peppermint flavor. I'm gonna try it maybe different ways. I guess I'm kind of disappointed because I've heard such positive things about it. I was really expecting more. So it's kind of disappointing to find that the flavor is lacking in this versus the pumpkin spice cake, where it was not. It's absolutely amazing. I bought 4 sleeves of that and I could not be more happy. With this, I can't confidently say that I'm going to repurchase it, but this is just my first pod and I don't want to give up. So I'm gonna keep going. But as of right now, I'm gonna have to say I'm kind of disappointed. It's not really giving peppermint pinwheel to me. For it to be in the title of the pod, it's just not really giving. But again, stay tuned. I will keep you posted if I can make this work. Please make sure to follow me on Instagram, Coffee and K. I will be trying out different recipes with this pod more to see if maybe I can get some of the peppermint, maybe pull something out of it. I don't know, we'll see. Anyways, it's a bit of a letdown to be honest, but thank you so much for watching. Please make sure you like this video, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel. When you do subscribe, please don't forget to hit the notification bell so you are notified whenever I upload a video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. I'm sure that I'm